So, the best team series. A lot of you guys thought it was over. I thought it was too. But with a lot of popular demand from almost everyone, it's back. And with this time, a new twist. The alternate starter Pokemon in the region. That's right, and today, I can say that we're starting over again in Kanto, Fire Red and Leaf Green, with Blastoise as a starter choice. Know that this isn't the original best team for Kanto, Fire Red and Leaf Green. That video was made 2 years ago, and I will leave a link to that in the description and in the iCard. The majority of you probably know what the best team series is, but then again, we also have a lot of newcomers to the channel, so let me explain what the best team is. The best team is a team of six Pokemon that is designed to best take on that region. That team does the best against the gym leaders, rivals, evil team, elite four, and champion. Now this isn't technically the best team for taking on the region, but the best team if you chose Squirtle as your starter. A lot of you guys like the idea of me using the other starters, and personally I think it's a great idea too. Before we get any further though, let me explain what we don't include in the best team. First off, I try not make teams that are version exclusive. This time however though, I'm going to make an exception because the two best options for fire types are version exclusives. This will only apply for this best team for Blastoise. Secondly, I will not be including egg moves, and I will be including tutor moves if they are obtainable before the Elite Four. Egg moves are impossible because you can't breed until Four Island anyways. One more agenda I want to address is the fact we are starting on Fire Red and Leaf Green. The reason behind this is because we started last time with Fire Red and Leaf Green with the best team for Kanto, so I want to start this series in the same order we did originally. Alright, that's pretty much it. Let's get into the shell-shocking team. Starting off this team, we have the obvious starter, Blastoise. Blastoise, out of the three starters in Fire Red and Leaf Green, I thought was the second best option, with Venusaur being the first and Charizard being the worst choice. There was actually a point where Horizon and I were actually thinking Blastoise could be the best starter, but Venusaur still managed to win due to some interesting conditions. Is Blastoise bad? No, absolutely not. In fact, if you're actually looking to speedrun Fire Red and Leaf Green, Blastoise is actually the best starter choice. Watch some speedruns and you will see why. A little more information on Blastoise though, it's a very well-balanced Pokemon with decent stats all around, even having 78 base speed. It has a much better move pool than it did in Red and Blue, so we can do a lot more with it as well. The reason Blastoise isn't the best starter is because there are a lot of better water type options in Fire Red and Leaf Green. Regardless though, it's still a solid starter choice. It can definitely do a great job for you on your journey. Blastoise's moveset is a bit basic, but I think it will work for the purpose of its role in this best team. The moves I want to give it are Surf, Strength, Ice Beam, and Bite. Starting off, give Blastoise its early water moves like Water Gun, and then eventually upgrade the Surf in the Safari Zone. Strength is for the sake of moving boulders, and we kind of need it. It also has 80 power, and we needed a good filler move slot. The normal Pokemon we get later on will have much more powerful normal attacks, so I really wouldn't rely on it that much. Ice Beam because coverage against grass types, and what water Pokemon doesn't have Ice Beam on it? Ice Beam can be obtained from the Celadon Game Corner for a lot of coins, so be prepared to spend a lot of your money, or if you want to spend hours in the slots, be my guest. The last move is Bite, and that's there for Psychic types and Ghost types because there are no Dark types in Fire Red and Leaf Green. Blastoise is well against Brock, Misty Starmie, Blaine, Giovanni's Ground types, Agatha's Haunter and Gengar, Bruno's Onix, Lorelei's Slowbro slash Jinx, Lance's Dragons, Blue's Rhydon, Alakazam, Pidgeot, and Arcanine. The second member of our team comes from the original best team for Kanto being Nidoking. Nidoran can be found on Route 3 in Fire Red with a 14% chance, and in Leaf Green with a 1%. Yes, it's rare, but oh, I guarantee you will want to pick this thing up. This purple Barnisaur is an absolute monster. Nidoking is obtainable literally right after you pick up the Moonstone instead of Mount Moon, and you evolve Nidoran at level 16. It also gets Thrash, a move that has 120 base power, 6 levels after you fully evolve it, and even gets Dig, a 60 base power ground type attack, Stab, from the Rocket Grunt outside of the Broken Into House after the player's trials in Cerulean City. It dominates the early game, and it can remain strong even in the late game. Nidoking is just an overly all amazing Pokemon, with its amazing stats and great move pool. You can have a fully evolved Pokemon after you get the first badge. That's how crazy powerful it is. Also, evolve your Nidorino right away because there's no point in waiting. It gets Thrash at level 22, and all the poison type moves it gets pretty much suck. And you don't get Sludge Bomb until post-game, so that's why you evolve it now. For the final moveset I want to give the Nidoking, I want to give it Earthquake, Thunderbolt, Ice Beam, and Thrash. Earthquake is here because of obvious Stab, Thunderbolt for those water types, Ice Beam for other ground types, and Thrash because why not, it's super powerful. Earthquake can be found after you defeat Giovanni at the Viridian Gym, and Thunderbolt can be found at the Celadon Game Corner. Nidoking is great against Lieutenant Surge, Erica with Ice Beam, Koga's Muk, Blaine, Lorelei with Thunderbolt, just be a little bit careful, Agatha's Arbok, Lance's team with Thunderbolt and Ice Beam if need be, Blue's Gyarados, Pidgeot, and Arcanine. Nidoking is a monster, and I am proud to have it back on the best team. Welcome back, buddy. Also, if you guys want to replace Thrash, you could give it Strength or any other filler move slot that you guys want. The third Pokemon we have on our team is Raichu. I never thought I would have used a Raichu on a best team, but then again, this technically isn't the best team, so I guess it doesn't count. Or does it? Honestly, I don't know. Regardless, it's here, and it's perfect for this team because we need an Electro-type, and our evolution slot will be taken up later if you do decide to take the non-version exclusive team. Pikachu can be found in the Viridian Forest. It may take a little bit of time to find it, but I don't think it's that hard. Pikachu and Raichu are both pretty fast Electro-types, and to be honest, I think they have a better move pool than Jolteon does, not by much, but by a little bit. However, if you want to use Jolteon, that is fine. I'm trying to give this best team a lot of options, just in case you guys don't like the choices. If you do choose Raichu, though, it's great, it's fast, it could take out most of the water Pokemon threats in the game, like Misty. There is a bit of water in the Seafoam Islands, and a little bit inside of the Precevi Islands. There's also a reason why I prefer Raichu over Jolteon this time around, because of the fact Raichu gets Thunderbolt via level up, versus Jolteon, where you have to teach everything to it via TM. Granted, you do have to evolve Pikachu at level 26, but I think it's worth the wait rather than grind up another TM at the game corner. Its special attack and speed may not be as great as Jolteon's, but I think it can work for the performance it can do. It's more convenient in my opinion, but like I said before, if you want to use Jolteon, there's no problem with that. Jolteon's still very, very good. Better stats, and yeah, it's I just prefer Raichu though. Raichu's moveset is similar to Jolteon's. There really isn't a lot you can do with it because it lacks a lot and most of TMs are post-game, so we have to make do with what we have. Thunderbolt for obvious stab, Thunder Wave to cripple down opponent's speed, Quick Attack for priority, and who knows, it may actually save your life, and Thief, which can be found on the second floor of Mount Moon. Raichu dominates against Misty, Lorelei's water types, Agatha's Golbat, Lance's Dragonite and Aerodactyl, and Blue's Gyarados and Pidgeot. Next up to the plate is, holy crap, Jinx? Yeah, Mr. Umbrian, apparently Jinx is on this best team. Well, I'll be a son of a gun. Looks like Jinx is going to be the fourth Pokemon on our team. Jinx is actually a tribal Pokemon that can be obtained in a house from an elderly woman next to the Pokemon Center in Cerulean City. In order to get Jinx, the player must first obtain a Poliwhirl. Poliwhirl can be found as soon as you pick up the Old Rod from Vermilion City. Once you have gotten the Old Rod, go to the route above Vermilion and fish for a Poliwag. Once you've found Poliwag, level it up to 25 and then go snag your Nicki Minaj Anaconda. Leveling up Poliwag shouldn't be that hard because of the SSN and access to the VS Seeker. A lot of people underestimate Jinx. It actually has a very unique and great typing, being Ice and Psychic. Psychic pretty much dominates Kanto, having Team Rocket's Pokemon mainly being Poison. And while the Ice type, it's just there for fun, and it makes Lance crap his pants. Jinx has a decent move pull, it's got great special attack and speed, and it made Brock a happy man. So Jinx's moveset, I will admit it's pretty fun to use, and it's hilarious because it has Lovely Kiss to piss off your NPC opponent, and because putting Pokemon to sleep is a good thing. So its moves are Ice Beam for stab, no duh, same with Psychic, and Water Pulse for other coverage. Jinx can have fun with Erica, Koga, Giovanni's ground types, Agatha, Bruno, Lance, and Blue's Venusaur and Pidgeot. Jinx seems like it would be a lot of fun to use. Let me know what you guys think about using Jinx in the comments if you do decide to use her. So the number 5 slot is going to have 3 options, being Flareon, Ninetales, or Arcanine. Flareon is for people that want to stick using a non-version exclusive team. If you're playing Leaf Green, Ninetales is your go. And likewise, if you're playing Fire Red, Arcanine is your go-to fire type. Regardless of what fire Pokemon you do decide to use, I can guarantee that any of these fire Pokemon will do decently for you. Yes, even Flareon. It's not that bad. But I recommend using the fire type exclusive to your game. So I'm going to kind of exclude Flareon from this explanation, and I'm going to focus more so on Arcanine and Ninetales. Both of these Pokemon are amazing stats-wise and are great fire types for their respective games. One factor these Pokemon have in common as well is they both evolve via fire stones, and one amazing feature that Kanto gave us was the ability to purchase stones from the Celadon department store. Fire is also special in this generation, and luckily for Ninetales and Arcanine, both of them have pretty decent special attack stats and speed stats for that matter. Luckily, they're both great, so it should be easy to use them nonetheless. So since we are talking about two Pokemon, I'm going to be making two separate movesets for both of them. But since they have similar movesets, it shouldn't be that hard to do. Arcanine and Ninetales will have Flamethrower as their default stat fire attacks. Vulpix can learn Flamethrower at level 29, so wait till then to evolve it. Growlithe is a tad different. You're going to have to pick up Flamethrower either right when you get it, or you can wait till later and use Flame Will for the time being. Regardless, Flame Will is still very good. The second move is Iron Tail, and once again, grab your wallet for that game corner or get your Vegas Groove on, because it's gambling time. Iron Tail is pretty much there for coverage against rock types. For the remainder of the moves, I don't know, you guys decide. Maybe Double Team for evasion, Hyper Beam and Arcanine to take advantage of its physical stat. Extreme Speed is also another really good option for Arcanine. Ninetales can run Confuse Ray, and that could come handy at some point. The choice is yours, to be honest. Both these fire Pokemon are great against Erica, Blue's Venusaur, Lorelei's Ice types, Bruno's Onix if you're feeling up to it, Lance's Aerodactyl, but I honestly don't recommend any of the rock types. Just have fun though. We didn't have fire types in the original best team, so tell me how well this duo does in their respective games. It's back. Our boy Peter Griffin is back on the team.
Great to be back, Mystic.
It's that last filler spot Pokemon, Snorlax. I don't know how many best teams this dude has been on. It's just so good. It has amazing stats, great move pull, and one of the best normal Pokemon in the entire region of Kanto. It's a great filler Pokemon from anyone's team, and to be honest, if it makes the Charizard team, it wouldn't surprise them at all in the least bit. You can get Snorlax after you get the Pokéflute from beating the Lavender Town Tower after Team Rocket takes over. Literally after you complete the tower, Mr. Fuji will give you the Pokéflute. From there, head over west of Celadon City towards Cycling Road, and then bam, wake it up. You can also go south of Lavender Town if you want to catch it down there, or if you mess up with Snorlax on Celadon, you can pretty much go down there and go capture it. Since Snorlax is also the filler Pokemon, use it as you see fit. Its moveset consists of Body Slam, Yawn, Seismic Toss, and Shadow Ball, which can be obtained at the game corner. Have fun, Peter. Well, that pretty much includes this best team for Blastoise Edition, Fire Red and Leaf Green. Though it may not be the original best team, I hope you guys do enjoy the other starters getting some spotlight. I also wanted to give a shout out to my friend Bird and his friend Curtis for help on this team. Go check them out, they are both amazing content creators. Links to their channels will be in the description below. Next will be Charizard, and I know a lot of you guys are probably excited for that. What do you guys think of this team though? Would you have changed anything? Let me know in the comments below. If you enjoy the video, why not leave a like and subscribe to my channel for notifications on, that way you never miss an upload. If you want to support me further, consider following my Twitch, where I stream a lot of Pokemon content like Shiny Hunting, Showdown Battles, and even Pokemon Mission Dungeon Explorers of Sky speedruns. I'm currently in push for partnership on Twitch, so if you guys could come down and support, I would love that a lot. Want to support me further and gain cool perks? Check out my Patreon. Fly Jubilee and Dana Leone did, and I wanted to thank them personally for going above and beyond. It means the world to me. I think I'm gonna wrap this up, though. I'm Mr. Gumbrown, and I will see you in the future for some more awesome Pokemon content.